learn to be happier. This step-by-step guide to happiness may seem radical to you, but they are necessary for long-term benefit. And I compile my life lesson hack to contentment and fulfillment to you in this video. Take a break from social media. Have you heard Donald Trump accusing the media by saying fake news to anything he doesn't like? You know, for us, social media can create fake expectations. And we are glued to our phone because we don't want to miss any of the updates. Either that you're in Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, whatever that may be. You know, sometimes we just check the update just a second ago. And one thing that is really crucial is that when we see a celebrity that we follow and we think that we can just be exactly like them. Marco Lacabani is a professor of psychiatry and behavior science at UCL, says that it is natural to want what others have because we have a mirror neuron that instructs us to do just that, mirroring others. And social media get them firing. You know, most of the people we follow on social media, mainly, you know, the influencer or the celebrity, are mostly sponsored by big brand, or sometimes, you know, they push their own product, and they are not independent as such, as you may think. They are biased. Then if we don't match up to that image, we can feel frustrated about ourselves and think that we are failures. You know, my advice to you is you don't have to quit, you know, social media altogether, but try to give yourself some break. And as well, you know, those neurons, give them some break too. They may need it. By making few visits to Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, whatever that social media, you know, you're on. And if you are an iPhone user, I guess, you know, Android may have that too. You can check how much time you are on your phone by going in your setting, and you can find that. You know, for example, for me, you know, that's what I do. Every time I go, I check how much, and then I reduce overall my overall time in social media. There are so much good learning you can do on your phone. If you feel bored and you want to keep yourself busy, you know, read something or build your skill. There's so much app that can help you improve your skill. And by improving your skill, my friend, you know, you can get some money paid in your bank account too. If you're still watching, maybe you find the video useful. Please, can you like it? Yeah? And also share with your friend. Sleep more. Feeling fresh and energized is a crucial part of a mood change and staying happy. It is easy not to prioritize rest with the crazy world we are part of it. We understand that. You know, your work needs your utmost attention. You know, your kid needs your energy. Society needs your vigilance. But getting enough sleep can help you adjust to that demand and greatly increase your level of happiness. In the research on well-being, academic Daniel Kahneman and Alan B. Krueger found a direct link between sleep quality and overall happiness. Try imposing a specific bedtime for a week or two and be strict about not staying up beyond that time. To help you fast fall asleep half an hour before the bedtime, stop checking your phone or watching any screen that displays blue light. Science proved that it will help you fall asleep fast. Here's a tip, yeah. Before you go to bed, yeah, go do your dishes, wash your dishes, or clean the house, and after that, go straight away to your bed. I know some of you have a routine which is linked with your kids' sleeping pattern. Look at way to affect that so that you can all go to bed at the same time. I mean, if it's a newborn, it's a different ball game. Yeah, we understand that, but you know, the rest is possible. Affect your sleeping routine so that you can get at least 7 hours sleep a day and your happiness will be on the rise. Be virtuous. Let's put it that way. If you have not committed a crime, you have nothing to feel guilty or afraid about. I know in some countries, being a different color or sexual orientation or political view can seem as a crime, but let's put that aside. I strongly believe that virtue is the key to happiness. You need to work out what drives you to misbehave and then address it. The only way we are going to get to happiness is if we are honest with ourselves about where our moral failings are. What makes you want to be unfaithful or drink too much or lash out? If you know the cause, you can change your behavior. You know, which is important because there's no way you can be happy without virtue. Find something to be passionate about. You know, what makes me happy is knowing where I am going, having a purpose in life, having a moral compass for doing good. It's about where you want to be and who you want to become. You know, as long as you know that you can follow the journey, and it is that journey that you are going to be excited and driven and passionate about, because you can see the impact you are having on your life and other people. It is having a goal that makes you happy. Take this advice and find a passion in your life, whether that is filming, cooking, motivating others, knitting, woodwork, animal rights or human rights, and follow that goal with determination. Have you subscribed to my channel yet? If not, please can you subscribe as well? That would be very useful. And also, you know, press the notification bell next week. That would be greatly appreciated. Forget the self. I think that we know we are naturally selfish, and also the world teaches us to be selfish. But to achieve higher happiness, one must lose the self. The art of a happy life is to be aware of the interbeing nature of everything. A rose is a product of a soil and sunlight and compost and water. And remove one of these ingredients, you won't get that beautiful flower which we come to adore and love. From our coexistence in the universe, we share everything with what it is around us. So we are the product of the food and drink we consume and the people we meet at every turn in our life. Try imagine yourself as a small piece of a global jigsaw. Accept, you know, suffering. This one, I cannot stress enough about the importance of accepting suffering in order to be happy. Suffering and setback are inevitable, but how we react to it, it is our choice. As a child growing up with all what I have experienced, I was very, very angry at times. But then the anger disappeared when I accepted my suffering as part of God's plan for me for greater things. We often try to silence and suppress anger or pain, but it is not about bottling up unhappiness, but allowing and place it in its place. Rather than denying suffering when you are passed up for promotion or feeling ill, try accepting it. I know easier said than that, but it may just help you to feel happier. The bad stuff in all our life, they are the rope which will help you pull out of the mud hole. Enjoy the here and now. Now is a moment which is guaranteed. Be in the present. The neighbor garden is not greener than yours, so love the stuff that is around you. We should try to enjoy each step, each breath, and each mouthful of food and feel grounded. On your commute to work, take a look around you and acknowledge the wonder in the world. Stay present and enjoy the here and now that is given to you, not the future. Be altruistic. Doing things for others and finding a way to give something back can make us feel happier. Happiness is a fleeting emotion, my friend. But what, for me, fighting for tortures you have has given me is a deep sense of fulfillment. Find a cause we believe in, or working or volunteer for charity can give us a wonderful sense of self-worth and help us to feel fulfilled and happy. I hope you find this video useful, and if so, you know, press like it. And if you are here for the first time, please subscribe to my channel. And I'm looking forward to bring you another great video, you know, next time. For now, I will say to you bye, and may God bless you forever.